Hey guys, Tim here, okay, VSCustomsSoCrawl.com. Now, I figured I'd finally talk to you about this body I was doing up for Chris over at GCM. I only showed this thing when it was white, and this is where she's at now. He's obviously seen it by now by the time this video's come out, and hopefully he's posted up some photos or some videos online about it, because I know I can't wait anymore. I'm just pumped. This thing is absolutely fabulous. Now, this body is put out by Extra Speed, available at RC Mart, and these things are super scale. I mean, fully opening front door, rear door, you have the hood that opens up, the back opens up, obviously all the other doors. The amount of parts, if you didn't watch the video on when I went through the box on these, the amount of parts that's in one of these kits is absolutely unreal. I mean, the fender flares are separate. The windows, each one of the windows you gotta put in. The roof is actually a separate piece that clips on and screws in, so there's actually two layers to the roof. It is crazy. Full floors, full everything. Like, I mean, you have everything you want under there. But what does that mean when you have a super scale body like this? You need a proper chassis. Something like an SCX-10 is definitely not gonna work on this kind of rig. You're gonna need something with a low floor or low transfer case on it, and the motor definitely up front. Luckily enough, GCM makes their new C-Max. That's what this is going on. That's what mine's essentially going on. And I really can't wait to see this on the chassis. Now, I've worked pretty hard on this paint. I've been doing it for, at least a couple months now I've been painting it. It's taken three of these little tester bottles just for the color. Now, this is I love this color, zinc chromate. You know, when it comes down to flat paint and painting things, I'm obsessed with this color. I haven't used it a lot, but I just love the way it pops, but still has that no sheen to it. It's always flat. It's nice. It's just perfect. It's perfect for those rat rod type builds. And then for the black, I used the Dupuy Color Flat Black. Now, this actually doesn't turn out to be as flat as, say, the Tester's Flat Black. This is the Tester's Flat Black on the doors. This is theirs, which is more of a satin finish, but you know what, at the end of the day, it works out perfect. It looks perfect, it looks durable, and it lays out nice and smooth. As long as you're, you know, painting on new panels, you prime it first. I go above and beyond. I prime it, I wet sand it, I prime it again, I wet sand it again, and then I paint it, and this is probably like three coats of black paint on here, just so that it looks nice and smooth and there's no issues with it. Again, just problems I have. But, no, this thing's turned out fabulous. All the airbrushing or all the rusting is actually done. It's four layers. It's I start out with a lighter brown, go to black. I spray another kind of brown over inside the black, and then I hand paint an even lighter brown on top of that to get that full out rust look. Now, if you guys are gonna be down at the Ultra Truck Scale Expo, that's it, the USTE, in Florida in March, this is going to be down there. I'm pretty pumped about that. I was in a rush to get it done. I've been off for a little bit now, and this was my main goal while I was off to get this done. I want to see this in the booth. I'm pumped. I really haven't had anything shown off, especially at a big event like that. So I want to have this done for Chris and have this down there. And again, he gets to show off his chassis at the same time underneath it. So keep an eye out for this. Definitely post up pictures, because I'll be waiting to see all these pictures coming out of the event down there. I wish I could go. Just, health stuff going on right now. I can't quite make it. I'm still trying to figure out what's going on that way. But send me those pictures, or at least post up the pictures, and I'll keep an eye out on the Facebook groups and stuff like that. But I'm pumped. And Chris, if you don't like this body, I will definitely gladly take it back and run it. Now, all the logos on here are painted on, so I use the GCM sticker on there, and I just painted it. Again, with the doors, this is basically the outline of it all. I put it on there, painted inside it, peeled it off. You know, I've heard of some guys that have some issues doing that. Keep the paint thin. I mean, I didn't paint with RattleCan. You can, but tape everything off and paint it at a distance so that it lays out, but lays out just smooth, but not very thick. But so yeah, that's all airbrushed on. Everything's painted on. I know previously we talked about no spare tire on the back, and I was just going to fill the holes, but I figured with the rust look, why fill the holes? Make them look rusty. So I rusted up all the holes coming out of the back, and that was it. So I'm pretty pumped. I'm pretty pumped to see if he puts it on the trail. I'm just fixing the seat here. I was talking to him again. He doesn't know the color. He doesn't know anything like that. For some reason, this kit comes with red seats. Now, I don't know why. Apparently there's others out there that come with black seats. At first I was skeptical. I was thinking, is red gonna work? But at the end of the day, it does. I mean, the interior is black. The accents are all black. A nice red interior sets off the interior, and the outside has the bright yellow on, or the bright green, whatever color you want to call that, and sets it all different. So I'm in love. Check it out down there, and definitely check out GCM C-Max chassis, because I know I will be checking one out real soon. I'm pretty pumped, and I can't wait to give them to him this weekend. So as I said, by the time you see this video, he'll already have it in his hands. But that's it for now. That's all I want to talk about. So like always, like, subscribe, and share. Follow along on Instagram under VS_Customs. Check me out on Facebook. I have a page up there, Tim Bleuer, aka VS Customs. And if you're looking for scale items like my CB radio that's inside this rig and many other things that I make, check out my Shapeway store. Again, VS Customs. I mean, they use the name everywhere, so you guys can find it easy. That's about it. Cheers.